does not have hockey on the map, but they're looking to do exactly that. Clemson is a football college. Could it become a hockey bet in the future? Well, we sure hope so. Now, is it another Seminole?
No.
There's just too many ill-advised penalties by the team wearing maroon, white, and gold. The team that once hosted the greatest quarterback in all history, Deion Sanders, is not playing like a Deion Sanders caliber athlete right now.
Short side post.
question from the cameraman is, why are there four refs? There's usually two. Well, we're in a higher level of hockey. Mr. Christian Goss, my videographer. When you're at a higher level of hockey, you need more eyes on you. There's two guys. Samuelson, the captain, out at the blue line, surveys the situation, and send it back down. Romeo. Romeo goes down low. Down low for the 24. Herbert Cox just comes back off the point. Pass over to Cox. Cox in the line of net, gathered up. Oh, losing his edge. Skating high over, lost his edge. And now, skating down to the Seminoles, but they will send it the wrong way. Going there. And gathered up with the Clemson. Here comes the Cox brother, Sully. Sully was defending that puck. Well, actually stay in the zone. Here's the cup shot! He's 22 years old, and of course he has a brother, and the brother's name is Sully Tom, and Sully's a forward, is a word for him. Oh, watch out for that shot. Playing the game the way you like to see it played. And no injuries at this time. We're very thankful for no injuries in this game of hockey. Down on the bench, we got head coach
Good game so far,
Ryan
right?
Smith.
Good game so far.
Say, hey guys.
Oh, yeah. 8-1 W.
We need to figure out a way to put a goal on the board. We have opposing penalties on both sides, and we'll go 4-on-4 hockey. Put a little more on the Seminoles. We'll find out. You know, God bless the Seminoles. They made a 7-hour trip here. How tired would you be after going for a 7-hour trip if you asked to play a hockey game 2 hours later? Probably be a more competitive hockey game on Sunday. We got there for Blomquist. Oh! Ryan Blomquist is a power on defense back there. Seems to always have the right decision to make. Pass the same spot back to his counterpart. That puck with the flush. Pass the bigger back up to the center. Pass the together there. And we're going to go back to another faceoff. 4-on-4 hockey still. 1:06 left in the penalties from both teams. 12:37 left in the second. The Seminoles are battling. You gotta give them, you gotta give them the props for giving everything they got. They're just absolutely not showing up on the ice today. That will come out tomorrow, and so we'll have another face-off. This face-off will take place to the right side of Sullivan. It looks like we're having a conference going on here. Get your coffee out. Time to sit down at the big giant table and have a conference. These are the moments when you take a look at a player
like the Seminole number 41 who's out there just kind of stretching and doing some of this warm-up activity? Because sometimes these Seminoles these conferences can last for five. I've seen them last 10 minutes, and you're like, get back to the hockey game. All right, face-off, offensive zone for the Seminoles. Can they capitalize? I hope we'll come back out. Walsh will just miss it. That's not what you want if you got a 5-on-3. They got a lot of time. 40 seconds left on the 5-on-3. They're coming Seminoles up next. Number 31. Back off the point. Just keeping it in. We're going to pass over. Watch out. There's a puck. Tom sending it forward. Oh, that puck will be a play. But the center's back on the ice again, though. Trying to pass up. Trying to stand up the troops of Ottawa. Running over each other on both players. But Tom gets over. Off the shoulder. Josh Bailey plays that just right in the shoulder save. Send it back out. 98-24 the Seminoles. They'll go on the backhand. Hold it for two. Send up them 32. Get it. South Carolina, the Pavillion. In the near future, your Clemson Tigers will be moving to the Greer Ice Arena. They will be playing. There. offsides.
Labeled it and said,
faceoff. We have a penalty still on the board. It is still a power play for the Seminoles. They have the lead. One more kick. Send the puck down in the corner. The puck is still on the board. Go behind the net. Ron Quist will flip it out of the zone. It'll go all the way down. Chasing this puck will be. Trying to set up his troop. He's pushing over the sideboard, trying to get it up to the half. Actually, center ice. Quick up to 31. Try to send it up. Punch is going to send it up. He's going to go down the road. McGovern will gather up, though. McGovern will wheel around, change direction to leave that puck for his fellow defenseman. Seminoles will come up the ice. Send over. Now the zone goes. Good hockey player doing his job out there. Been loving watching that player. Long quick. Fence down. Bumping it behind the net. Now and then up will be Clemson. But what a stick that this is fucked up. Trying to pass up, but defensive. O'Brien is there. Watch out, he's blocked. The second, it is a 10 spot. Seminoles are absolutely getting the effort, so they'll love the effort. Battle on the sideboards. Do I see another one there? I hope I don't. junkies out there, guess what's coming to Burger King in a couple weeks? You guessed it, the Ghost Pepper Whopper, baby. I like to eat, everybody, so hope you got a kick out of that one. The Ghost Pepper Whopper, one of the best fast food burgers you could ever eat if you like spices. And the colors really bring some pizzazz to it. Back to the offensive zone, a shot from out. Unorthodox stance in calling hockey. I like to say I'm one of a kind. Don't get me wrong, there's many that are better than me, but there are none that are me. Behind the next couple goals, the Clemson Tigers will look for him to go back on the D. Will Blomqvist. We'll send it over to the captain, Samuelson. On the back of the net, they'll get it off, we'll go to another draw. Can all you people out there in Hockeyland believe that the holidays are upon us? It is so hard to believe 2023 came and went so fast, and we're getting ready to close out 2023. This blows my mind. Seems like yesterday, we were watching the ball be dropped in downtown New York City, and here we are a few months away from 2024. A dirty hockey game. You gotta love the sportsmanship. Hey, all you viewers up there, moms and dads, all you moms and dads up in different parts of the United States, like Massachusetts. I know there's a lot of Massachusetts players on this team. And I've seen a few from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. And we even got a homegrown South Carolina player. I'm trying to remember the game. Let me see if I can find it.
You got this twin on purpose?
Yeah, from Seneca, South Carolina, Cade Heinold, who's been carrying the play the whole game, number 9, comes to us out of Seneca, South Carolina. Congratulations to coming out of an area in the United States that's not known for hockey. Who knows, maybe you could be the first person out of Seneca to one day graze the ice of the NHL. You never know. Keep on working, your dreams could come true. We have a conference going on down there. Head coach is not happy for the second. Ryan Smith is talking it over with the man in black and white stripes. And we'll go back to hockey. 23.9 takes down the clock. Oh,